The people here are not against building our community or bringing in this building. We're not against that. What we are against is the fact that they're willing to take out a part of our history in order to put this community center on it. The community is, there's 307 people who are in this town. I had a petition signed that over 100 plus people had signed it. And for it to be a community center that is basically going against the community's wishes, I think is absolutely wrong. It should not happen in any community and in any type where the people should have a say. This shouldn't happen.
Community TV honors and acknowledges that we create video content on Treaty 7, Treaty 4 territories, traditional lands of the Siksika, Kainai, Piikani, Stony Nakoda, Tsuut'ina, Cree, Sioux, and Saltino bands of the Ojibwe peoples. We also acknowledge that we are on Métis Nation Region 3. This content is created with the help of fans and local businesses that sponsor the content. Sponsors don't necessarily endorse all of the content, they support your access to relevant news and stories.
It's written in our history books, like everything is there. You can go back and you can look at everything. It is part of our history. And now it's being threatened and going to be erased.
Today, I was able to get in touch with Cypress County about this issue with the library. Cypress County's getting a library. They've decided it's going to be in Irvine, and more specifically, they've decided it's going to be at the Wanda Woodward Memorial Park, which was put together by the Lions Club there, and is a beautiful little park where I met some folks just yesterday, residents of Irvine that are concerned and are interested in having the plan revamped and looking at some different locations, one specifically, which is right next to the curling complex, recreational sort of sporting facility there with a lot of parking available. So residents seem to think that that's a better place for it.
We'll take you for a ride.
Awesome.
Absolutely. It almost is, I would say, like 95% in agreeance of where it should go with the community, with who I've spoke to and the members that I have talked to.
I've been trying to contact Cypress County, as I said, and today got a response over the telephone. They basically just said that they won't take any questions from the media. The county considered many locations and made the determination for the sustainability and viability of the Irvine Community Resource Center to be located on the site of the current Lions Park. An upgraded Woodward Memorial Park will be part of the new resource center. Cypress County is working collaboratively with the Irvine Lions Club to find a suitable location for an additional park. The county is excited to see this project become a reality. From my understanding, after meeting with the residents, probably over 20 residents there just at the drop of a hat showed up at the park to voice their concerns, that there are some concerns not being taken into account. And that one short line there, the county considered many locations and made the determination for the sustainability and viability of the Irvine Community Resource Center to be located at the site of the current Lions Park. So I guess they're going to have to explain, I guess they should have to explain to the residents how other sites were not sustainable or not viable.
This is my hometown. This is where I've grown up, and now I'm back here raising my children as well. My family's lived here for 40 years as well. So yeah, my kids have gone to school here. I've gone to school my whole life here as well. So right now we're in the, I guess it would be the Wanda Woodward Memorial Park, also known as the Lions Park here. In 1925, this was, the trees here were planted actually. They're over 100 years old. In 1987, Wanda Woodward was murdered, was kidnapped and murdered in Medicine Hat actually. And she was a big member, and her family was a big member and lived here for a lot of years as well. It was horrible actually, and a lot of people are still here and have known her, went to school with her, and we're good friends with her too. So, and the family as well, even one of her cousins I had grown up with as well, there was members of her family killed on the train track. So they had like a lot of history here in this town. It is something that is a sensitive subject, and I know that not everybody who have moved in from now on out really understand that story. So I'm wanting to try to get across that it is part of our history here. What actually happened is they ended up closing the doors to public, so it ended up being something that was not appealable anymore. We could not speak our minds about it, that it was basically looked over. There's a few people who are really trying to push this project and are willing to overlook the 100 plus members in our community in order to get what they want.
I wanted to provide you some interviews with the people that I met in Irvine. Unfortunately, we're not going to get much back from the county other than that press release there.
This council wants to reduce the green space that we have. This is southern Alberta. We don't have a lot of trees. We don't have a lot of green space. Why take it?
One of the councilmen said, it's going here no matter what you guys say. That's what he said. I'm not giving you the exact words. I said to him, so what was this meeting for?
Yeah.
What was the meeting for when you already have made up your mind what you're going to do?
We live right
there.
That
was one of the questions I was going to ask. Is anybody here that lives right there?
Yes, we do. And we would like to say that throughout the summer, or throughout the year actually, we see a lot of people using this park, like travelers coming through, they stop. And they'll have a picnic. You see them stop and let their kids out to use in the park and that. And then, like I said, they picnic. And we've actually had bikers on pedal bikes. They come and they've camped in this little hut overnight. And then next morning they're gone before, you know, daylight. We get up and they're already gone.
In the summers, we would go to the parks and everything. And now that I have a three-year-old daughter, it's nice to be able to go to a park when the school is in, because you can't take a child there when the school's going, you know, because you can't be around the other kids. And the other big thing that I don't want to get rid of the park is, like, if I have another child, these are the only baby swings in Irvine. So, like, you can't take them to the other park because I got rid of those swings. And even, like, she's three, she can't really play on that park. There's not much that she can do. She loves the slides. Like, she does it by herself, and it's perfectly safe and fine. Like, I don't know, it's just...
I'm guessing that if you had a kid in either side of Irvine, one of the rules would probably be don't go near those train tracks.
Absolutely, yeah.
I don't want you crossing over to the other side.
Unless you have an adult with you, absolutely. So, like, I know that there is quite a few kids on this side and they go to this park more than they go to the other park. But yeah, it's just having the public park on this side is really good, because, like, when school's in session, you know, we just go for a little walk, maybe get the mail, and we'll come over here and we'll play for like an hour, you know?
I buy my pet food from Rob at Animal World. This is the very rare occasion where the people of Irvine have stood up to say that they want to go in just a slightly different direction, across the tracks, take a right, take another left, and you'll be right there.
Now 3:41, it took us 1 minute to get from one site to the other. This is one of the sites.
This is the complex.
See the parking lot?
Yeah.
For starter, there's a parking lot. Mm-hmm. Up.
And this is four times the size of the place we were just
at. Absolutely, and not only that, but there is the Irvine School. So kids, when they get out of Irvine School,
okay. They
can come to the library if they're wanting to spend some time there at the community center. That right there is a great ag society.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if you've heard of it, but they have animals there and sheep and everything there. So it's, sorry. And it's, so they have a whole bunch of animals and sheep and, they do a whole bunch of agriculture stuff, kind of teaching kids,
yeah,
you know, all about farming and ag. And so, not only that, when people come here, they're coming from out of town, so they have to bring their families. I'm a mom. I have three kids myself. So when I went and dropped off my daughter at volleyball, I had two very bored kids.
Mm-hmm.
So if I had the choice to walk across the street from the complex to take my kids over to the library, and if they were to build their little park that they're wanting to build and have them go there and spend time with them while my older kid is in mm-hmm. practice, 1,000 times over I would do it. So not only is it actually being helpful to another business in town, you're being helpful, it's useful, it's going to be used a lot more than it would be on that side of town. And it just makes more sense. And knowing that that side of town was flooded in the 2010 flood, to build a new building on there with the potential of it possibly getting flooded again, there's no reason in my mind that they
or that that's a better spot for this place.
Truckers, 24/7 restaurant next to the gas station on the right-hand side of the number one highway as you come into Medicine Hat from Red Cliff. Truckers is a home-cooked meal and a very popular stop for cross-country truckers. Check Skip the Dishes for Truckers tonight. Do you need a lawyer? Call 403-527-3030, the law office of Yarshenko and Heidinger. If you've been charged with a criminal or regulatory offense, the law office of Yarshenko and Heidinger has experience, skill, and the demonstrated track record to professionally and ably guide you through the legal process. If you've been charged with a criminal offense, the law office of Yarshenko and Heidinger wants to represent you. Call for a consultation, 403-527-3030. That's 403-527-3030. Call my lawyer, 403-527-3030. Great local prizes.